Many people don't think that there is such a thing as a black non-believer. They don't think we exist because many of us aren't open to talking about it because of the highly religious climate in the black community. Historically, the church was a safe ground, a huge support base for the black community after slavery and Reconstruction, when laws were set to effectively work against us. So the church became an institution that built schools and provided support and community when we basically didn't have much else. Because of the comfort, that the hope, that belief in God gave them, that passed down through tradition, and it passed down over the years, and it just seems to not have stopped since. It is unfortunate as well because it tends to disregard the doctrine of suffering and also how the church really has become detrimental to our community. The Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King, which doctor should be first? He was an actual PhD. And we tend to disregard and overlook one of his heroes, Mahatma Gandhi, who was Hindu, as well as one of his advisors, Bayard Rustin, who was a black gay man, but couldn't be out at the time of Martin Luther King's activism. And yes, we do tend to ignore certain figures like A. Philip Randolph, who was one of the key organizers for the March on Washington, folks like W.E.B. Du Bois, who was one of the founders of the NAACP, as well as writers like Langston Hughes, who many in the black community do applaud. However, they tend to overlook the fact that he challenged religion. And there were many other notable figures who were free thinking and who were non-believers. And I think it's very interesting that now the religious community holds up Martin Luther King in such high regard when before the end of his life, he became much more progressive and he became a much stronger advocate for human rights and not necessarily from a divine aspect. So that part of his legacy and what he thought about certain members of the clergy and how they were falling behind does get lost in the sainthood narrative that is his legacy. And I think that it's important for us to take that back. There are solutions that we need to have for our community that we're not getting, and almost willfully not getting, because of people putting their faith first in your life, that you must have Jesus. You cannot do this without Jesus's help. To have faith has been to ignore the sense of progression that we need to see in our community. We've always pushed for education, but unfortunately, that emotional tie to the church is keeping us, our community, from being as progressive as we can be. If you openly identify as an atheist and reject God in any way, if you are black, then yes, it is equivalent to rejecting the race. We have been able to effectively increase the number of openly identified black atheists and non-believers and people who have expressed their dissent with religion since 2011. And we're going on 5 years. It's like we've been told that we're like a breath of fresh air because we talk about subjects and issues that they would never be able to discuss with their religious family members and friends without being judged and without being ostracized. Please know that Black Nonbelievers as an organization and as people are here for you. We understand what you've been through. We understand what you're going through. So please know that there are others out here just like you who go through the same things you have, who have been there, and we are more than willing to help you. There is a community that is growing. We are building, and we love for you to be a part of that.